So good morning, everyone. My name is Jorge Fonseca. Thank you for watching this presentation, and I hope you're having a nice event. So what I'm about to show you is a next generation airline passenger journey from check-in to an arrival airport. And our journey starts with the online check-in. So in this concept, as a future passenger, what I want to do is I want to share my data in exchange for extended benefits. So I will only share, I will not only share my documents, but also my social profile, my preferences, tokens, my medical data, and biometric data. I will assign this responsibility, the responsibility to mediate the communication between the airport services and my trusted providers. I will assign this to my personal assistant, that little robot over there. And what will happen is that the airport service gate will request information or authorization to my personal assistant that will request information to me. I will confirm, get back the temporary tokens that will be shared to the service neurons. Each service neuron will represent an airport entity or airline. And then those service neurons will be able to communicate and share information with my trusted providers and back to my personal assistant. So given this important concept, we start our journey on the day of the flight, and we arrive at the airport. So once we arrive at the airport, the big change here will be a check-in not of a flight or an airline, but a check-in at the airport. So what I do once I get to the airport, I can use any of my pre-shared authorization tokens. This means I can use my passport, my national ID card, any of my devices, wearables, my biometric data, or any payment card whatsoever. Everything will be pre-registered and will be mapped back to me. So the airport service gate will inform me, will inform the entities associated, including my airline, and will begin following me across the airport. It will give me some quick guidance, some directions, and advice on my next steps. I will also be able to print my bag tags in the spot, print my tickets, hotel reservations, or print a temporary QR card just to get me through the gates. So, given that, I continue my journey to backdrop. So, on backdrop, what I will have is bag tags that will be tracked via RFID so that I will be able to know where my bags are in the airport, if they're in the flight, or when they will arrive at the destination airport to know when to pick them up. But they will also have integrated GPS GPS mechanisms that will allow me to know if the bag was lost, if it was not boarded, or if I have to do anything else to get my luggage back. So, bag drop done, on my way to security. Getting to security, or on my way to security, cameras on the airport with artificial intelligence will actually monitor me and evaluate my behavior and match it with criminal records. They will have time during the time that it passed for me to get the security. They will have the time to do all of those mappings. And once I get there, what I will have is 3D scanning of my bags, which is helpful in the sense that it will be safer. It will not require me to take my laptop off, for instance, or take any liquids off. Things will be quicker. And also for body scans, what we will have in body scans will be several layers of scanning that will check for metal, chemicals, even check my body language, my temperature, my heart rate to see if there's something wrong or something funny with my behavior. All of this will be done in real time with artificial intelligence analysis and ponderation, so it will be quicker and less prone to error judgment. So, passing security done, this stressful phase, let's move on to something nicer, shopping. I get to my duty-free and I'll do my shopping and it's time to pay. In terms of payments, the important change will be that I will be able to use any of my tokens, any of the previous tokens that I've used on airport check-in, on bag drop to interact with these machines. So again, I will be able to use any of those tokens that will be mapped to me. What about security? Well, security will be done not by banks in the first instance, but by my personal assistant itself. So if you think about it, my personal assistant, it knows my voice, it knows my face, so it can call me to check if it's me that is holding my bank account card, can even do a video call to check if it's really me, or even if it's me, it can check for signs of stress. So am I in danger? Do I have an altered behavior? And if necessary, it will call anyone from my family, or it will even call authorities if my PA identifies there's something wrong. So once I've paid for it, and now I want to collect it. I can take it with me, or I can ask to be collected at the departure gate, or I can ask to be collected at the arrival airport. In this case, it doesn't even need to be the product that I bought. It could be the same product, but from another inventory on a distant airport that it's synchronized with my original airport. So shopping done, I'm on the move. I'm on the move, and what I want to see, what do I want to see? Well, I want augmented reality to know, first of all, the directions. Where am I heading? So how long does it take to get to the next checkpoint? Should I step up? Should I move faster? Do I need to go slower? So the augmented reality will give me that on my phone. Excuse me. It will give me that on my phone. But it will also tell me more things. So it can tell me, well, where's my mom? I can look for her. Okay, my mom is in the ladies' room. That's why I couldn't see her. Where are my kids? I can get all of that from this augmented reality. And it will also know what's on my to-buy list. In that sense, it can tell me that in this shop, there is this item that I need to buy before I get to the plane. And it can also check for social profiles of other passengers. So I might see that John is over there. John is an engineer, and he's going to sit two rows in front of me. I can start a conversation. I can check his LinkedIn profile, because he shared that profile as in the same way that I did. So it will be a better social experience. Also, while I'm on the move, remember that the airport is tracking me. It's tracking my biological data. It knows how I move. It can identify me quickly. So I do expect the airport to alert me if I forgot my bag, alert me if I'm on the wrong way, if I'm late, if I need to step up. It will alert me on the phone, and if I don't have a phone or if I don't react promptly, it will show it on, it will sound it on the speakers, the alert. So, still on the move, and I'm passing by the wall boards. Those wall boards will be smart enough as well to know that it's me just by proximity. So I'm passing close to the board, and the board will change to show up the information about my flight, to show the directions where I need to go next, how long it will take me to get there. And this will be on my own language, and it will be on my own pace. So the time it will take me to get somewhere else, it depends on the group I'm in, the medical condition of the group, the average pace of that group. So the information will be the information for me. And it will only matter exactly where I'm going. So the directions are for those points only. And with this, it will also advise me in terms of getting priority lane if required to get there faster, to make sure that I don't lose my flights. And will be information, so impulsive sales that I really care about, not generic information. So it will be customized to me and to me only. So fantastic. How are we on time? We still have time. So we're going to stop at the restaurant. We still have time to eat something. Restaurants. I get into the restaurant, and I tap somewhere with any of my devices. Again, the restaurant knows about me. It received the information from the airport. It knows my seat preferences, food allergies, flight plans, special requirements, and it knows the group I'm in. I just need to confirm the group, who am I sitting with. Not everyone is coming to lunch. So I sit down on the table that the restaurant said it was the best table for me, according not only with my preferences, but with the social preferences of the people around me, to make sure I'm with the right group of unknown people that the restaurant knows. So the menu that I receive is the menu that is synchronized with my preferences as well, so it will be my food that I enjoy or that I can eat. Also, because it knows my flight and it knows the queue in the kitchen, it will know that some of the options will not be valid options because I won't have time to catch the flight. So it will give me exactly what I want, what I need, and what it's feasible according to my reality. So, food taken, going away. How do I pay? I can pay with a phone, but if I don't have a phone to pay, I can, again, use any of my tokens with a little kiosk, and on that kiosk, I can use my tokens, get the bill, print it out, and walk away. So, a very simple experience. Restaurant done, I'm on my way to the gate. Get to the gates, and usually, I don't know about you, but usually gates are not always a relaxing experience. Well, sometimes they are boring, and sometimes they are painfully frustrating if you are on transit and you have to wait quite a few hours for the next flight. So it's a shame that companies are not taking advantage of this sales opportunity. So what we will have in the future is the ability to prepare our flights, prepare departure and landing. So what I will be able to do is I will be able to buy extra legroom. I will be able to swap seats on my flight because there's a seat available next to someone that is socially interesting that I would like to speak to. I will be able to also pay for any extra bags if I didn't have time to do the bag check-in. And I will be able to prepare my land, buying third-party auxiliaries, so rent a car, hotel, whatever, even book my next flight, because I'm with a family, we're all waiting there, we don't have anything to do, we're all together, we can buy all of these things right next to the gate and make the best of the time that we're spending there waiting for the flight. So the time to wait has ended, and we're being called. For boarding, things will change as well. What will happen is that boarding will be personalized. Everyone will be called by the seat number or by the name. And we will enter the planes in an organized way that by recent studies have proved that we can actually board our planes currently in half the time that we usually do. So by naming the boarding of people. Because the airport knows where people are, knows where I am, knows where the group is, the airport and the gate, the artificial intelligence in the gate, will be able to postpone anyone that it's required an element of the group to come in because it's late or something like that. It will also upload all of my information to the plane. So in situations where planes won't have internet connection, any connectivity, my preferences, my movies, the media that I bought on gate, my selections will be uploaded to the airplane. And when I get to my seat, I will have my name on it, and I will be able to interact with my seat to get my movies, my trip, my alerts, my menu, connect my Bluetooth headphones, and I'm off to having a great flight. But because this is not enough, I will also have a fast internet connection. So the European Aviation Network is building a network currently with satellites and ground antennas that will give fast internet to the airplanes. This will allow me to continue to prepare my flight, the same things I was doing at gate, but it will also allow me to buy duty-free and collect at arrival with inventory management, will allow me to do some delayed landing management to see what's the next gate I have to go to when I land, the directions I have to take at the airport, the flight status of my next flight, or even change my flight if necessary if my plane is so late that I won't be able to do that connection. And it will also allow me to do some disruption management. So if my connection flight is canceled or delayed, what do I do? I need to talk to the airline company, but why do I need to wait for it until I get to the ground and go through all of those queues? If I can do it, I have a computer in front of me in my chair, and I can interact with the airline company directly from there. I will also have light-based internet on seats. This is important because current Wi-Fi is disruptive, so it interacts with the airplane, while light-based internet does not interfere with any of the equipments of the airplane and will give me a very high throughput of information. Allow me to watch online movie streaming or play high-resolution games with someone else in the plane, with the family or with other passengers. So a really nice experience while we're on the air. And finally, we land. When we land at the arrival airport, so everything that we did on the plane will be downloaded to the data centers. What was synchronized in the air is synchronized in the air. It's waiting for me. So I'll go through the border security, which is fast already, but will be faster. Why will it be faster? Because my biometric data that current machines have to read, the airport will already have that biometric data and just has to match with any of my devices. And will also be tracking me from the departure airport to the arrival airport. It will track me from the moment I leave the plane. So it won't need to do the calculation of biometric match while I'm passing through the gate. It will do that over time while I'm walking. So it will be fast to go through the security, and then I'll go to, I'm going to collect the things I bought on duty-free, check the papers that I asked to be printed, reservations, tickets, and so on, get all of that. The shopping that I did on the duty-free of departure will be there as well. Collect everything and wait for my bags to be ready to be picked up. I get a notice on my phone saying that it's ready to be picked up. I get my bags and I'm off to my next means of transportation. So while I was in the air, I actually booked my autonomous flying car. And I also booked for my wife the Hyperloop ticket for her to get to our next destination fast, and I know that everything is fine, and my family knows that everything is fine, because at home they will be receiving push notifications sent by the airport itself and by all of these other means of transportation saying that everything is fine and I'm on the move. Also, once I get to my Hyperloop, I will have a similar experience where I'll be able to continue to watch the movie I was watching inside the plane. And so continue to do the same experience, the same shopping I was doing, the same session will be synchronized back to this next means of transportation. And I'm off home. So that's me. Thank you for attending. Let me tell you that the credits to the videos in this presentation are not mine. So most of these videos are real technology existing right now, and some of them are prototypes, like the last that you saw in flying car, that's a prototype yet. But most of it is real, so it could be used nowadays and interconnected so that we could have, not in a far distant future, but on a near future, we can have this type of experience for customers. Apart from the drawings, so the drawings are mine, but you can use it freely to basically help the general population to get a better experience and get it for yourselves as well. So thank you.